With the first spectra out of the way, I want to get to... not down there. Anyway, it doesn't matter because the way to go now is totally in the right or opposite direction of where that was. I'm not able to get to that elevator in time. I'm gonna call them elevators, but I don't know what you call them. They're like moth elevators or butterfly elevators. Yeah, I don't know. But they somehow defy gravity, and they somehow operate without any kind of power source. So, oh, the third thing Garden 9 introduces are these things. The fake pollen crawler mines. As you can see, they're not pollen crawlers, but they're mines. And just to demonstrate, I will hit one of them. Ow, it hurts me. Not only that, it takes away time, which is the most important thing. So, definitely do not want to hit those mines. Go. I'm gonna hit the pump. Go. Actually, this is that one's a bit more trickier. I'm gonna head this way and collect pollens here. There's a lot of pollens right here. But god damn it. In Garden 9 and 10, all the gardens gathered up like that, it's not really good news. Maybe in the earlier gardens it was okay. But in Garden 9 and 10 it means that you might end up dropping all the way down to the bottom. I don't even know how I missed that moth elevator. Come on, are you kidding me? Also, I think the background for Garden 9 is quite crazy. It's like a psychedelic trip. Rainbow colors that are fucked up. That's what I like to call it. You know, because they're not really rainbow colors, they're colors of an LSD drug, what an LSD addict would see. Actually, that's wrong, you can't really get addicted to LSD, but you know what I mean. It's an acid trip. Which I really found interesting when I was reading this book about harm reduction and drugs and stuff. Really crazy that there are absolutely no withdrawal symptoms for LSD and PCP and hallucinogenics as opposed to heroin and cocaine. And actually, like the worst withdrawal symptom seems to be not actually heroin or opium per se, but morphine. That was interesting. I'm not downplaying the horrible effects of. What the hell is wrong with my controller? I'm moving to the left way and it's taking me to the right. So definitely something is wrong with the controller. But anyway, as I was saying about drugs, don't know why I'm talking about illicit drugs as I'm playing pictures of Eden. But it is definitely an interesting topic for me. I really like reading a lot about it. Particularly because it's, you know, there's a spectra right there, I forgot. But in many ways, I have a personality where, if there's something that I know that is, like, really considered to be, like, conventional wisdom by the public, but it's really not that accurate, or if it's, you know, just not talked about, not discussed in a proper way, I have a humongous interest in those things. You know, which is why, you know, I'm not a religious person at all, not anymore anyway, and, you know, my dad's a pastor, so I was born as, like, all my life I was really a Jesus freak, but now I'm an atheist. So I have no religious, you know, aspect at all, but for some reason, still, because the public conception of Islam is so way off base, I took a class on Islam, and what is Islam, and I found that really intriguing, because that's kind of the guy I am. I mean, what the public misconception is, I want to get the right conception, and I want to actually get the crystal to not die and fail. Let's see, crystal right there. There we go. Now that I got Crystal, listening to, I believe this is Motley Crue. Like I said, the Pandora tends to stick with the genre. I had to skip through like 4 rap videos because I wasn't feeling rap today to get to this genre again. So it got to like AC/DC, Motley Crue, Warren, all of them. The classic 70s rock, which I really like, but I really have to be in the mood for that kind of music, really. More so than rap. Because rap, you know, the kind of rap I like, the oldie raps that like have social justice themes and stories behind them, really enjoy those pretty much any time, except maybe some days I'm just feeling for like corny pop or something. Hey, it happens. Don't judge me like I see in a lot of other videos. So this one is easy too, you just gotta swing around here. This one goes there. And this is the one you use to get the spectra on this part. Here, I believe, I think I have to go a little bit down. Okay, can't really see because of, okay. Yeah, got the second spectra. That one's easy, see? The third and fourth spectra are a little bit more fun. At least I tend to think so. Let's see how Garden 9, everything is, the non-grippable surfaces are all laid out in a horizontal way. And the spectras are placed right below at the end of the platforms, which is what makes me work around the level design. Which is interesting. Garden 10 is the exact kind of the opposite way, in that the non-grippable surfaces are placed in a vertical way. So Garden 9 is horizontal. Garden 10 is, let me say that again. Garden 9 is horizontal. Garden 10, vertical. But Garden 10 is by far, in my opinion, the most annoying garden of them all. More annoying than Garden 7. And there's a reason for that. It, like, you know, it introduces a new concept, of course. And that concept is frustrating. Stop swinging around. Come on, let's get up there. Okay, wrong way. Oh. I was shaking down my controller, because I thought I was up in the air, but no, I was still in a grip mode. God, stupid type C, oh my god. And I'm gonna pause and change my controller, because I really hate this controller for this game. My controllers are changed, I don't know how much better this is, but at least it's not giving me low battery warnings. Which might have affected my, controller. Gonna wait for this to go. You again? What the? You jerk! There we go. Are you kidding me? No! 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 I feel like that was definitely like one of the worst ways to fail the garden. Or one of the most unfortunate ways, at least. Seriously. Come on, get there! Didn't get to it. Third spectra is right there, but I'm not really aiming to get to that. And this controller is actually acting the opposite way of my previous controller, and that is leading towards the right. My previous controller was... You again? Come on. You gotta be kidding me. There we go. Good riddance. Yes, got the third one, but I wasn't actually intending to drop down. It's okay. I think getting 2 spectres in one video is good, right? Am I being too greedy for wanting to do 4 in one video? Perhaps, at least for Garden 9. But I quit right here. Got in the tent. Never mind. I meant next video. I'm stumbling over words for some reason. Gonna get the last two spectros. Or maybe just one spectro. Don't expect too much.